Hello guys, welcome back to the channel Dr. Mom. It's been some time since we have uploaded a previous video, and the very good reason for our absence on YouTube is simply because I have been formulating, devising and putting together some curriculum for kindergarten and pre-kindergarten kids. Now we know that we are all living in very uncertain times. I have come across a lot of parents who are very hesitating to send their kids and toddlers to school. Keeping this situation in mind, what I have devised is a very basic curriculum, a syllabus which includes both the ICSE, CBSE and all the boards, so that it would be easy for the child when they are going into schooling in a later stage. So the basic concept of homeschooling is very simple. I'm just going to share my ideas of homeschooling with my kids. If you have been following on my YouTube channel or on my Instagram account, by now you would know how I am bringing up my kids. Starting from this month, I am going to share with you a weekly and a daily planner with all the subjects or the activities that I am going to cover with my kids, and which is going to be useful for you also. So do subscribe to my channel and follow me on my Instagram account to get the daily updates on my stories. So another thing before starting today's video I would like to say is that a lot of you have messaged me and asked me about the products, that where do I purchase them from. So keeping all that in mind, I have jotted down the links for all the products that I have been using in my videos as well as on my photos on my Instagram, and I have linked all of it on my description box. So if you could go to a particular video and click the description box, you would find all the links of those products that are being put up in those videos. In today's video, I am going to share about some of the DIY activities that I have tried to enhance the fine motor skills of toddlers. Fine motor skills are those skills that involve the very tiny fingers and the tiny muscles of your hands and toes, and these are require a lot of precision and coordination and concentration. It gradually develops over a period of time, and very rarely do you see any delays in fine motor skills, and most of it is linked to either premature birth or some kind of syndromes. The very first activity that I am discussing here is the using of straws, or inserting straws into an old Pringles can, wherein we have just made holes for the child to focus and put those straws inside. There are a lot of variation in this game, in this activity. You can make wider holes and make the child insert coins, make the child insert buttons and things like that. So the thing that is involved in this activity is a very fine motor skill that is being enhanced. There is a concept of problem solving and spatial orientation. The child is aware of where this exactly the straw has to go in. So he's trying to focus on the small holes and trying to put it inside. And he's learning to grasp the straw, in fact learning to hold the pencil. So this is one kind of a pre-writing activity, I would say, if you're using the straw. So activity is a DIY board, wherein I have taken a normal piece of cardboard and have stuck few zippers into it, a different colors for them to teach the colors also. You see, Mizan recently started scribbling out when we were coloring around. So what they have to do is just learn to zip up and zip down. So again, this is involving fine motor skill and, like, you know, teaching the child how to hold this and do these movements. So, hello, Mizu.
Dad.
Kya khelte?
Dulu.
Acha. Open karo. Open. Okay. So DIY activity is of creating mazes or something like this. You just take normal plastic baskets and tie ribbons or thread it down through the holes. You just have to make it a little bit complex for the child to pull out the things. You can put pom-pom balls. I have used a small building blocks here. You can use any other toy that you're having. What you basically do here is just try to take out the building blocks. Either the child has to take it through the hands, or you can offer them spoon or tongs, like, you know, they have just to take it out like this. They have to search and make spaces, like, from where they can take this out. So taking out. So this is one activity where they're trying to concentrate on particular boxes, like particular space where they have to put in or take out. another variation of this activity is using spoons to take the alphabets. What we have done is kept a tray and filled it with water and a lot of alphabets. They have to just take the, it's like alphabet scooping activity. You just have to scoop in the alphabets and transfer it to a small muffin tray. So this kept them engrossed for quite a time. They were busy for almost 1 hour. They enjoyed water splashing at the end of the game. So what I tried to do is I used alphabets so that they keep learning and reinforcing the alphabets. So the fine motor skill activities involved, the cognitive activities involved, the hand-eye coordination activities also involved, because they're trying to concentrate on taking, lifting and transferring things from one container to the other. The next activity that we have done is forming the alphabets or tracing the alphabets. I have used marble pebbles. I just gave them the normal flashcards and they just have to form the alphabets here, just like this. They just have to place the pebbles. You can use buttons, coins, you can use food beans, food seeds or anything at your disposal, and just offer them anything. You need not only give them alphabets, you can draw patterns, you can draw shapes, anything. The concept is just for the child to hold the tiny object, see that it is kind of little tiny, hold the object and have to fix it on that particular line. It is involving a lot of concentration and again a lot of fine motor skills and problem solving method. The next activity is creating or recreating shapes. What we used the normal flashcards for them to see the shape. What shape is this? This is the triangle, and they have to form a triangle using their ice cream sticks. Variation of this toy is you can get these Velcro stickers and cut it into half and stick it on either end so that actually you can fix the popsicle sticks like this tightly, and it will not come out as the child is playing. It will not move around. The problem is, in this lockdown I couldn't go out anywhere to buy such things, so we're just trying to hold it up here like this, just forming the shapes, keeping it one on top of the other and just forming the shapes. They are learning the number of sides a shape is having. For example, the triangle has three sides and they are trying to make it of the same color. They are trying to make of a different color. So this activity also is a very hit. They are sitting with it for almost half an hour. It is keeping them engrossed and it is very easy. This last activity is threading. Threading is a very important activity for the enhancement of fine motor skill. You just have to thread in here. You just have normal threads and you just have to focus and put your threads inside. This was one wooden board that I got depicting the Arabic alphabets. So you need not always buy this. You can take cardboards and draw shapes and punch holes in it, and you can offer these twigs or these laces for the child to try. A lot of times I'm asked what are the different activities that we can try at home for enhancing the fine motor skill. What I have discussed in this video are a few DIY activities, but the day-to-day activities for the child, like buttoning up their shirts, lacing their shoes, pulling up their zippers, and basic things like holding their spoons to eat, tearing out the rotis, chapati morsels for them to eat, using of scissors, using pens and crayons to color, using paint brushes to color, threading activity, using straws and putting pasta pieces into the straws. And when exactly does this fine motor skill develop? Most of the time when the kid is around 9 months of age, they start to try to clap their hands. That is when they learn to use their fine motors, they learn to use their fine muscles of the hands, the fingers, the thumbs and things like that. So in this video I have just discussed a few DIY activities that we can do from the comfort of our home. I have not discussed any age appropriate activities. I will be putting up videos shortly wherein I will be dividing the kids into age groups, and accordingly the activities that we can introduce in those particular ages can be discussed, like the activities, the toys that you can buy for those particular activities, the DIY stuff that you can do. So all that will be concentrated age appropriate. So keep tuned to my channel to watch those videos, and do follow me on my Instagram account to have a daily update of all the activities that we are doing there. Cumulatively it gets recorded up and then I would be putting up on my YouTube channel here. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, subscribe to the channel right now. Share this video among your friends who you think can get benefited out of it. Comment in the comment section for me to know what more you would like to watch, or what are the different things that you have tried with your kids. Stay safe guys and take care. Thank you. Have a good day.